Look at something called Rom Toolbox. So with Rom Toolbox, it's a collection of tools for those people who are rooted. Easy enough. In here, you've got ROM management. So if you're the sort of person that loves to install custom ROMs from the community, you've got that in there. An app manager, it's basically an uninstaller. The root browser, now this is probably one of the most useful features for anyone who runs root. This will allow you to actually get into your data folder. And this is where the actual gubbins, really, of all your applications are stored. So regardless of Titanium backup, which kind of is a quite simple interface really to actually allow you to get into all of this data and back it up, you can just copy these yourself if you wanted to. Titanium backup does a few other things as well. It helps to freeze an application so that you can actually back it up without causing other problems. But you know, with Root Toolbox, you've got a way to get directly into your root files, make any modifications you need to there. There's a scripter and terminal emulator for those people who are into more throwing Linux commands basically at your device. An ad blocker, auto start manager, config for apps to SD. That really doesn't work on Samsung devices. And a quick rebooter as well. But also in here are abilities to control your CPU and kernel tweaks. And another really useful feature is the build prop. You have to be really careful in build prop if you're rooted. You can basically destroy your phone, or at very least destroy your ROM that you're currently running. You have to reload your ROM. One thing that a lot of people like to tweak, certainly on the Galaxy Note 2, is the LCD density. Mine is set at 290. The default is 320. The lower you go, up to a certain point, the smaller on-screen text and icons become. You can fit more on your screen. A lot of people on the Note 2 like to tweak it down a bit just to make the icons feel a little bit more sharp and contained. One note of caution there, do not drop that too low. I think if you drop it under about 270, the Android keyboard, the Samsung stock keyboard, stops working. And you'll probably have to reinstall all of your software again on your phone and re-ROM to get everything working again. 290 is quite a nice, happy medium, I find. SD booster, you can go into here and you can actually set the cache value, I believe. The higher the cache value, the faster data will be stored and read back from the device. You can then run a benchmark if you want and it will calculate which setting you should probably be using. I tend to find 1 meg is more than ample and does quite a good job. But that's ROM Toolbox. You also have some interface controls in there, font installer, boot animations. Once you have root level access, you can change the things in your device that you don't really like. A lot of people really like changing their boot animations from the stock Samsung one. Again, things like the status bar icons and theme chooser. So you can change up all of these icons up here and so on that would appear across the top of your screen. I've seen some really nice custom Wi-Fi logos, for instance. All of that is available once you root.